So the fun they had here, they are the children who belong to which era? The children who belong to? Yeah. 20? Yeah. Okay. So it is this. So that is 22nd century. So here in this chapter, we are talking about the children of 22nd century. Am I right? The fun they had. Are the children in this day the ones who belong to 22nd century? No. Here we are talking about the children who are talking about the children who used to have fun in
school
in 21st century and before that. You people are in 21st century. You people are in the school. You are having fun. You are having fun. That's why you are coming to school even in this kind of situation when many children are not coming because of some fear, but you are coming thereby risking that thing. Because there is some fun in the class that you people have realized very, very well during your 1 year of stay at home. And before 1 year, we people used to have different opinion about online classes and offline mode because we had never experienced that. Then that kind of thing in India, especially, was a big deal. Like children can study while being at home. That was considered as something very, very big. But now 1 year has made everybody realize that no, there is no education without school. Because it's not just about education, it's also about the holistic development of students. And the holistic means all-round development. So what is all-round development? When the child is growing physically, mentally, emotionally, intellectually, psychologically, spiritually, aesthetically. So many things are there for the growth of a child. And all these things are not, one cannot get all these things while being at home. At home, one can only go for intellectual growth. Okay, only intellectual growth is possible. Rest of the growths, they are at stake. Because when 20 children are together, they learn from each other so many things. When one child is scolded, other 19 children also get some lesson. When one child is getting a prize for something good, the other 19 children also get some skill for what that child has been awarded. So there are so many things the children learn when they are together. First of all, they learn to be together. They learn to collaborate. Okay, they learn to learn the team or leadership qualities. They learn so many things. They learn the quality of sharing, caring. Okay. So when somebody is scolded, they just don't mind it because there are so many others, those who are like them in the class. Okay. So there is, you can say, there are many chances of growth for everybody, for all kinds of children. Okay. And aesthetically, because in the school, the way you are to present your matter, what is aesthetics? Do you know what is aesthetic? Aesthetic senses, which makes you perceive beauty. If you write something that you say, when your friend says, okay, I've done my work, you say, wow, you've written it so well. It's your aesthetic sense which makes you realize that something is presented in such a nice manner. Okay, when you say, no, it's not looking nice. Okay, you people make charts and then what happens? Some child say, no, your chart is not at all good. Because the color scheme is not good or the font size is not appropriate. And the others also say, yeah, that's good or that's bad. It's the aesthetic sense which makes you judge whether something is looking beautiful or not. Otherwise, there would be all disorder, chaos, dirt, right? Dullness all around us. So if you have a look at your classroom all around, you will see that, yes, it has a certain... aesthetically, the classroom has been settled. The class has a aesthetically well-settled plan. At your back, there are charts which have been made up on white sheets with black write-ups, but the way the color scheme has been given it to them, that has made those black and white charts look vibrant. See the aesthetic sense, the one who's thought like this, right? The way the display board is set up, see the aesthetic sense. To this side, the green board, right? So aesthetically, the things are set, and these things you people value later on. Right now, you might be taking it for granted, like, yes, all the schools are like this. But when you will move out of the school, then you will realize that, yes, are that school, you know, used to be so well set. There didn't used to be a single desk where we used to scribble in the last year. Then the next year, we would never see those desks back with those scribblings. Such well-planned system is there in the school. It's not only here. In all the good schools, it is like this. Right? So when you are in a good school, then a good school should make you also good. And it is all up to us whether we learn it or not. So here in the story, the fun they had. So here basically, they refer to the children who belong to 21st century or even before that. All children below 21st century. Okay, you people are coming to school. Your parents used to come to school. Their grandparents used to come to school. Okay, so these people. So here they are we people actually. Okay, they are the present generation. So the fun you people are having, that will be missed by future generation. They won't have this fun. Okay, the online mode which has come up now for education, it will not go away now. This is what I feel. To some extent, it will remain there. Right now, there is an option. And slowly and gradually, maybe after 100 years or so, keeping in mind the kind of pollution, environment, traffic, the resources, fuel, energy, then maybe online mode will only be the option. It's just not about Corona. And Corona is also there because of these things. Okay, pollution, traffic jams. So many other problems are there. And Corona has made many of those problems become silent. You know, last year, when in the beginning, you people might be remembering, during the complete lockdown, what happened? The nature revived. Okay, sometimes when we don't take care of the nature, then nature starts taking care of itself. It's in a way, now the nature is taking care of itself. So let us also take care of nature. So in this chapter, they are the children who belonged to present generation, that is 21st century or even before that. So it is about the fun which we people are having now, but our future will not be able to have. Why won't they have that fun? Because they won't be able to go to the school physically the way these children or the 21st century children are able to have. Right? And why they are not able to go to school? Because there is online mode. Okay, they are being taught not. Right now, the online mode still I am there. I am addressing these children who are there on online mode. A very physical teacher is there. I mean, physically I'm there. But after 100 years or so, and you people also know now Alexa has come, robot has come. When robots can do everything, they will start teaching also. So when the robot will be teaching you, they won't tell you like, beta, behave properly. They won't teach you any sense. They will simply say, beta, the fun they had is about the school, which they used to miss. And in the school, they used to have the books, they used to have the pens, they used to have the friends, they used to have the teachers, and they used to enjoy a lot. That's it. The chapter finish. Okay, bye. Do the assignment. That's it. And next day, if you will not submit the assignment at 5 o'clock, they will not see, like if you were not well, if you had some problem, they will not see to it. Your marks will be simply deducted. And in the end, the result will show whether you are passed or failed. Okay, so when the mechanical teacher will be teaching you, yours no, nothing will be assessed. Your emotional IQ will not be assessed. Your psychological well-being will not be taken care of. So there will be nothing, only your intellectual growth. That's it. So is only intellectual growth of any use? No. So that is in this chapter, basically, we have been told only about the children of the 22nd century. They are missing the school. They are missing the way the children in the school enjoy with their friends, with their teachers, the way they share their books, the way they read from the books. The books have these words written on them, whereas on the screen, the pages flip across. Okay, the moment you turn your page, that page goes. No doubt you can recover the page. It's not so. But the thing is that easier, they would be wondering as to how can there be a book with fixed words on it. Okay, what you people have it, what you take for granted, the children in 22nd century will be amazed at the things like books, at the idea like how can 20 or 50 children be sitting together? How is it possible? The children who are born during this corona period, God forbid if it should not stay like this forever. I don't even want to speak up what is coming to my mind. I guess you are getting. They won't be able to imagine like how you used to have fun in the school. No, I don't want to complete that part which was coming to my mind. Because it is said like we should not speak negative things quite often. Okay, we should speak good things. So those children who were born in this corona time, 1 year, they will be able to have a full view of what school life is. No? They will be, because the times will be good. Everything will be fine. Life will come to back as usual. But we should know one thing, that we must take care of nature. Okay, we people have become very selfish. Okay, we can analyze how we are selfish, how we don't take care of nature that we can see on our own. So here in this chapter, the children of 22nd century are talking about the fun the children of 21st century and before that used to have. And the fun was all about in the school with friends, with books, with teachers, and the way they used to share care for each other. Right? So that is basically this chapter about. And in this chapter, when we are talking about the fun they are missing, we also come to know about the life those children in 22nd century will have. What kind of life? A very dull life. Waking up, sitting in front of the screen, getting the lectures coming from a robot, teacher doesn't even bother whether the student is learning or not. Why so? Because the mechanical teacher has got a system which, as per the age, is giving lessons. So when this girl is not able to get on well with one subject, what happens? When she's failing continuously in one subject, what happens then? Yes? Who is the headmaster here? No, that is okay. The girl feels that she cannot do this. She becomes disappointed. Okay, she becomes frustrated. But my question is, what is done? What steps are taken to solve the matter? Yes. Here the principal is county inspector.
They call the county inspector and the county. And when the county inspector came and checked the robot, and the level of the robot was not all right, and ma'am, he set the level of the robot.
Yes, well done, Jia. Okay, so what was that? The county inspector is called, and that county inspector, What do you think that county inspector, what kind of person he might be? In your own language, what do you think he might be? Mechanic? Huh? County inspector might have been the software engineer. You know, the one who might have been robot expert. You know, the one who might be expert in tackling the robots, programming and all. Okay. So in simple language, it might be somebody like us, a software engineer. He came and set the level of the software. So if you set these software work as per the commands given to them, right? So he just came and set the level which was required for that girl. And then she started doing well. So what do you learn out of this incident? Jia or Janvi? Jia. Yes, come. So what we learn out of this incident? Come here. So the county inspector comes, sets the level of the software, or you can say the robot. Then the girl is able to manage. So the point is, what we learn out of this incident? Ready? Come here. Do you want to give answer? Yes. Anyone who wants to give answer can come. Yes. Come in. Come. Don't touch. Yes. Come.
From this incident, we came to know that no one can take the position of the teacher and job of the teacher and the topic the teacher taught cannot be taught by the robots.
Okay, I don't really agree with it. Okay. Yes, come and give. Let's see what you people think about it. Yes, ready? Come and speak. Don't touch.
Ma'am, that the robot do not know what to speak, and he's doing according to the system. But the teacher tells according to the class, according to the students, and according to the class.
Yes, you are right. So yes, okay. It's okay, like what you people are saying, like teachers teach according to your level, but the robots, they teach, they go on and on without making out whether you're understanding or not. But doesn't mean that the robots or the softwares are useless. Doesn't mean this. Okay, these systems, the softwares or the internet, they are the ocean of knowledge. Okay, it is up to us how much drops we need. We can have the drops of knowledge, we can have a pool of knowledge, we can have a river of knowledge, we can have the full ocean. That is all up to us. But yes, one thing is there, when the physical teacher is teaching you, then he or she can see your emotional growth. And along with the physical teacher like us, you can have an access to yes, softwares for your complete and more knowledge. Okay, combination of both physical as well as mechanical teacher can do wonders. Getting just one teacher is not sufficient to keep in pace with the knowledge, which is exploding with every second. There is knowledge explosion. Do you know? Okay, within 1 minute, there are new things are coming up. How would you update yourself? You just cannot rely upon just one physical teacher. You have to rely upon you have to depend upon softwares or internet also. Right? So yes. So read the chapter carefully. There would be so many things in between. And tomorrow there would be some MCQs which we would be discussing. Now the time is almost over. But before the bell goes, answer my questions. So Tommy walked away with the dash book beneath his arm. Which book? Tommy walked away with the dash book in his hand. options are torn, T-O-R-N, dusty, D-U-S-T-Y, imaginary. Number four, real book. Dusty. Even the real book was correct answer. But in the chapter, it was written like it was a dusty book. So you have to choose the most appropriate answer, which is there in the text. So he walked away with a dusty book. Dusty is the correct option. Okay, next option now. According to Margi, in an older time, the schools were, options are big, brown, funny, or stupid. Big, brown, funny, stupid. What's the correct option? Funny. So according to Margi, in the olden times, the schools were funny. Do you know the reason why she thought like this? Why were they funny? Okay, right. And think about it. And tomorrow an answer would be asked from this very question. Why did she think the schools were funny? Okay, next question. Whose father knew as much as a teacher? Wait. Options are, whose father knew as much as a teacher? Tommy, Margi, Blair, or Evelyn? Evelyn. I'm repeating the options. Whose father knew as much as a teacher? Tommy's father, Margie's father, Blair's father, or Evelyn's father? Read the chapter and find the correct answer. Don't give me the answers like that. Those who are saying Blair, Evelyn, they don't know the chapter at all. Have you got your books? Find out the answer. Whose father? Then why are you saying like that's the correct option? Find out the answer. Yeah.